Hi, I'm Jessica with the Pain Free Athlete, and I'm here to introduce the pelvic tilt. This is one of the exercises from my book, Winning the Injury Game. You can find detailed instructions on this exercise on pages 189 to 191. This pelvic tilt is the first movement that you do in the hamstring and glute bridge, which you can watch in another video. You're gonna start lying down on your back. You've got about a 90 degree bend in your knees. Your arms are out to your sides, palms up, anywhere between 45 and 90 degrees. Whatever is comfortable and allows you to roll your shoulders back and into the ground. The general movement is from the pelvis. You want the pelvis and all the surrounding muscles doing this work. You're gonna notice that your back lifts and lowers as you do it, but it's not just arching and flattening your back. It's a movement from here where the rotation from the pelvis is gonna lift the back off the ground, and then the rotation back is gonna flatten. And we're gonna talk about integrating this with the breathing. When your arms are to your sides and you want to be looking straight up, I'm just turning my head for the video. You're going to inhale through your nose, and as you do that, your back is going to lift as your pelvis rotates forward. And then as you exhale, you're going to rotate that pelvis back. You're gonna press your knees out a little bit to help engage your deep transverse abdominis muscle. Your rib cage comes down in the front so that you get good alignment from your pelvis through your rib cage and through your core. So we inhale through the nose as the pelvis rotates forward. And then exhale out the mouth as the pelvis rotates back, the rib cage rotates down, and the knees press out. The whole time, you're trying to maintain a relaxed upper body position. You also want to notice your foot position the whole time. They might start to move or you losing contact with part of the foot. So that's why it's nice to have bare feet or socked feet like I do today, so that you can feel what's happening in your feet. But of course you can still do this exercise if you have shoes on. So one more time, inhale through the nose, arch the back, tilt the pelvis forward, keep the upper body relaxed. Exhale out the mouth and let the back flatten, knees press out, rib cage comes down. Now the last piece you can add to this is a little bit of a lift in your pelvic floor. And that would be on the exhale. As you exhale, you just lift the pelvic floor a little bit like you would if you were trying to stop the flow of urine. And you always want to do that, you might know it as a Kegel, you always want to do that in combination with your breathing, because the respiratory diaphragm and the pelvic diaphragm are just two ends of your core that need to work together. So that's the pelvic tilt. Thanks for watching.